Good morning, Wanda Faye here. It is Thursday, October 19th, 2017. Good morning, hope you're doing well. Let's get into the Word of God, okay? Let's go over to, praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for this day. Okay, let's just read the word, okay? Let's just relax and faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. Psalm 91. He that dwells or dwelleth, King James Version, in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For He shall give His angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet. Because He has set His love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him. I will honor him. With long life will I satisfy him, and show him my salvation. Thank you, dear God Almighty, for your word and your promises. Your promises are yea and amen. Lord, I thank you for all the people out there watching this video and that will watch the video and beyond those watching this video. We intercede for our family, our precious loved ones, our friends, neighbors, the towns and cities we live in, the neighborhoods we live in, our states we live in, and our country we live in, the United States of America, and Father, all the countries in the world. Lord, thank you, God, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Thank you, Father God Almighty. Thank you that we can be patriotic in our own country and be proud Americans. And for those people out there in the world, Don't be jealous of America. Bloom where you are planted and have faith in God. God gives us all the same chance. And yes, America is great. And yes, God is making America great again and greater than even than it was. And yes, these could be the last days. It always could be the last days. So we all want to be ready for Jesus to come back and to for us to occupy until he comes, to be about our business, okay, to be about what God has you to be doing, the good things in this earth that God wants you to do, whoever you are. And I thank God for our new president, President Donald J. Trump, that God gave us President Trump, because God knew our country was on the verge, okay. And praise the Lord, he sent him. So I take authority over all the hell and the evil and the lies that have come against him in the name of Jesus. I speak Psalm 91 over our president, his team, his family, and his team. And that you give him wisdom, Father, in the name of Jesus. Now, I'm all American, girl, okay? I'm all American. Morningstar International is all American. But there is this factor, this Jesus factor, that God so loved the world. So, you know, we're not limited to who we talk to, who we preach to, who we minister to, who we pray for. And the liberals in this country have turned their back on freedom, so to speak. They have twisted good and evil. And so I pray over them that they would just see the light, you know, and learn and stop being stuck in their lies. Like I was, like I ignorantly was back when I began to study for myself. I began to do my own research. So I encourage you, I'm not picking on you, but I'm asking God to help you do your own research and truly search for truth and news and truth about things for yourself. Don't rely on the mainstream media for your news, you know, because they're going to be biased. They're going to be biased. And so, praise God. I thank God for you out there that might be watching. And whoever you are, and whatever side you're on, God still loves us all. Okay? He's so gracious and so long-suffering and so merciful. So I pray over everybody out there that you would have a really good day and that you would be safe, that you would be healed, that you would have every need supplied, job, career, whatever dream, whatever you love to do. May the money follow, yes. If it's a good thing, then may the money follow, yes. And just thank you for watching. I'm still working on getting better at these broadcasts. I could have really cut this off at 5 minutes. I really could, and I just thank God for helping me overcome some issues in my own life that have held me back. But you know, it's okay, because the last shall be first, and the first shall be last, and so we just keep Keep on keeping on. Keep on keeping on, okay? And I always say the best is yet to come, and it's going to get better and better and better. Okay? You have to have faith in these things. Okay? Have a really good day, okay? Get in the Word of God for yourself and follow Jesus. Don't be following any... I'm not saying don't be faithful to your pastor and church, but don't follow them, so to speak. Follow Jesus. Get in the Word for yourself and know Him for yourself. Don't put the pastor or the minister or the church above God. That's idol worship also. And it's good to be faithful to whatever God has you faithful to. Faithful to Him first. Faithful to your family. Faithful to your marriage. Faithful to your children. Faithful to those loved ones God has given you. Faithful to your friends. Faithful to what and who He wants you to be faithful to. So don't get me wrong there. But don't get bound up. Don't be bound up in religion. If there's going to be an organization called the church or ministries, may they be doing good where they need to do good. What happened to visit the orphan and the widow? You know, this is pure religion, the Bible says, to visit. Now, don't just be rushing into their house and going, well, we're here to visit you. Knock, knock. We're here to visit you. Don't. No. Be gentle. Don't shove yourself into other people's lives just because you think God made you the overlord of somebody or, you know. And I pray for pastors out there that you would be faithful to feed your flock. God's church is starving for His word. Not your little games, not your little programs, not your little five-step this and three-step that, and just to make you money. And I'm not coming against anybody. If that's how God is leading you to do things, then so be it. And touch not mine anointed, and do my prophets no harm. I don't speak evil of the TV evangelists, because praise God we have TV evangelists that preach to the world through satellites. So be careful who you're coming against. We all have our own style. Every pastor, every preacher, everyone God has anointed has their own style. Joel Osteen has his own style. Be careful who you're coming against. Because God made us all individually, unique and different. And the gospel shall be preached in all the world, and then the end shall come. And so we're all doing that. We're all planting our seeds the best way we know how. And, you know, let's give each other a little grace and mercy. Take the log out of our own eye before we try to take the toothpick and the splinter out of somebody else's eye. Judgment begins at the house of God. Yet He's merciful. Father, wake your church up politically. Help the pastor stop hiding behind the pulpit because they're afraid to speak their opinion about somebody or something or government. And they think that, oh, well, we got to preach the gospel. Yeah, you can do both, okay? We have become who we are because possibly because we didn't want to talk about politics and religion. So here we are. Our country was on the brink. And I pray over the pastors that God hold the pastors accountable for not getting involved, for being afraid to say to the children, to the youth, to the adults, be open to what God might have you do. Be open to becoming a congressman or woman. Be open to become the mayor of your town or city. Be open to be the leader in our government. Okay? So, praise the Lord. God bless you. And don't forget social media, that God gave us social media. Okay? This is a great tool the Lord gave us. Don't forget, we can use it all. He's raised it up for us too. He's raised it up for us first and foremost. But He's raised it up for all so that we can communicate. Communication is important. Talk. Don't hide. Don't hide behind the congregation and telling secrets in your little prayers, little curses over the congregation. Those people are hurting out there. They're sick. There's some in the congregations that are sick that need your prayers. You got healed by God. And you take it lightly that somebody in your congregation is sick. Don't leave it out. You can do it all. Pray every single service for healing for God's people. And preach the word, not your nonsense of a light gospel. You need to talk about hell every once in a while. Do so. Don't leave it out. If you believe so much in the salvation of souls, stop leaving the hell factor out. Are we trying to scare the hell out of them? Darn right. I hope I'm not being too hard on anybody. But let's have balance. And balance is not whitewashing things. Don't curse the darkness. The darkness is already cursed. People are begging for truth. People might be coming against truth, but they're really begging for truth and authenticity. So I pray over us all that will help us to have be fearless and speak the truth in love. Hallelujah. And I guess I'll end this now. Have a really good day and have fun. God bless. Bye-bye.